Hi, this is Wayne Besson, author of Anything But Straight, Bashing Back, and the founding executive director of TruthWinsOut.org. Today, we're going to bring you an exclusive interview with Michael Hamer, who represented a client who said he may have been infected with HIV from former ex-gay ministry leader Michael Johnston. One day, after my old radio show, Hamer called me to tell me about the impending scandal. He told me to get down to Norfolk right away. I took the next train.
My client was a mental wreck, very much afraid that he might have been infected with HIV. As I recall, it was on through gay.com, the local chat room. Well, they met and they had had sex. I get the impression not always safe sex, and hence his high level of concern.
These allegations were stunning. Michael Johnston was Jerry Falwell's personal ex-gay leader, did a video with the American Family Association, and also worked on a commercial with Coral Ridge Ministries. Additionally, Michael Johnston was the founder of National Coming Out of Homosexuality Day and worked with anti-gay activist Peter LaBarbera.
My client had a couple of concerns. One, possible recourse against Johnston if he had gotten infected. Secondly, once he realized who he was, he had an interest in the story coming out that this guy, despite going around and speaking, selling videos and selling books, wasn't cured, as they like to claim, at all.
We took this information to Southern Voice, Atlanta's GLBT newspaper, where the American Family Association admitted that Michael Johnston had a moral fall.
In order to have Michael Johnston prosecuted, my client would have had to identify himself. He was very concerned, based on his employment at the time, that if word got out, he'd lose his job. So even though Johnston could have been charged with a felony, because it is a felony in Virginia to expose people to HIV without telling them you're HIV positive, my client was afraid he'd end up unemployed and didn't know what else. I would hope at some point someone will be willing to come forward, use their name, and have them prosecuted.
While in Norfolk, we discovered several more men who claim to have had unsafe sex with the ex-gay leader. Following the scandal, Michael Johnston was shipped to Pure Life Ministries in Kentucky. He remains there today as an employee. Amazingly, the American Family Association still sells Michael Johnston's fraudulent ex-gay video to its members on the internet today.
It's unbelievable that they would try to get him back out in front of the public again. And as for him, I think part of it is it just shows they're ex-gay for pay. Why else would you keep doing it?
For more information about the ex-gay myth, visit TruthWinsOut.org.